All right, well, let's go now to Maryland, and we'll talk with William. Hi, William.
Yeah, hi. How are you today, sir?
Hey, good. What have you got for us?
Well, I was watching some program once, say, and there's an author. He made a statement that in the New Testament, nobody ever asked for patience because they already had it. Uh-huh. And I thought, I couldn't dispute it. Maybe this is a trick to get me to read even more or something, but does that make any sense to you?
Well, it does make sense to me, William, and I think there's some wisdom in that. Let's talk about what I mean. I mean, first, as a foundation, we know the Bible says we've been blessed with every spiritual blessing in Christ. So among those spiritual blessings, of course, would be the gift of patience. Everything is in Christ. Christ doesn't need any more patience. And if Christ lives in you, then you don't need any more patience because you have Christ. Now, let's follow this through. I mean, the Bible says we're complete. It says we lack nothing. It says we have everything we need for life and godliness. So we don't have to run around begging and pleading and hoping and waiting and reaching out and trying to grasp for more patience. God, give me patience. We pray these sort of things sometimes, don't we? Give me patience. Give me love. Well, patience is found in Christ, and Christ is found in you. Love is found in Christ, and Christ is found in you. So that's what it means to bank on the sufficiency of Christ, to say that He is enough. We didn't just get a ticket to heaven when we got saved. We got Christ in us, our only hope of glory. So what it means then for us to live the Christian life is to draw upon His life, to depend on His life. Eternal life is not your life made longer. Eternal life is not your life made better. It's not your life added on to. Eternal life is Christ's life, His very life given to you. So Jesus gave His life for you on the cross in order to give His life to you at salvation, in order to live His life through you every single day by faith. He gave His life for you, to give His life to you, to live His life through you. And in that life, in that resurrection life that is contained inside of you, you have all the patience in Jesus. So I think that's the way to look at things. That is an accurate statement that you heard, that we don't need to go shopping and hunting and begging and pleading for more patience, because patience is a person, and so is love, and so is kindness, and so is gentleness, and so is self-control. It is the fruit of the Spirit, because that is the character of the Spirit. The Spirit of who? Well, Romans 8 says the Spirit of Christ dwells within us. So all of this, these riches, these spiritual riches, are found in Christ, and Christ is found in us. So next time you catch yourself saying, God, bring me more patience. God, give me more love. Well, I know what we're saying. We're saying, I don't feel very patient. I don't feel very loving. But if we're asking God to swoop down out of heaven and deliver a gift package of patience or a gift package of love for today, He's not going to do it. You know why? Because He told us that we have Christ and that He is enough, and that after we have Christ, we don't need to hunger and thirst for more, because we are filled up and complete and lacking nothing and blessed with every spiritual blessing in Jesus. And Jesus is in us. So, William, I hope that's an encouragement to you. You can be patient today because Jesus is patient in you. You can be loving today because Jesus is fully loving in and through you. That's the truth that'll set you free. You don't have to beg and plead and hope and wait for some new portion of an attribute to come your way. No, the Spirit is in you, and we can bear His fruit in any moment. Call back anytime, William. I hope that helps. We'd love to hear from you again.